How's it going, everybody? Mackie coming at you here, and I'm really excited about bringing to you this video because this is something that I have always dreamed of, and I'm gonna do my best to share as much of it with all of you in hopes that it inspires you to keep going after what it is you want to go after. Go after your dreams, never give up, work your ass off, and don't let anybody tell you otherwise. I am in Cloverdale. I'm actually, I don't know if you can see it, up there was where I ran my sales office. It's if those walls could talk, the stories they would share. I'm about to embark on the most epic road trip from Canada all the way through the United States down to Mexico. I've done it once, but it was in the Mazda and it was an old car, but I get to do it in my dream car. And there's some really cool stops along the way, some people I'm gonna be meeting. And like I said, I just wanna bring as much of it to all of you as possible so you can share in the joy of this. So with that being said, let's get to it. All right, let's go. All right, we are officially in the United States. The border was interesting. What I'm doing is a little unique. Family's in Mexico, so I go to Everett, Moab, Boulder, somewhere in Texas, then eventually Mexico. He's like, wait, what? He's like, I don't understand your job, or there are drugs in the truck. I'm like, fuck no. But anyways, he was pretty cool with it. And so I didn't even need a secondary. So, win-win. All right, good morning. It is Saturday. 6 hours of sleep. Felt extremely well rested, and it is fucking time for the most epic road trip of all time to officially commence. So I need coffee because shit ain't working properly yet. So let's get the show on the road, shall we? There she is. Exactly how I left her. All right. Oh, looks like it's gonna be absolutely fucking gorgeous today. So, what's on the agenda? Breakfast. I'm gonna hit up a little diner or something. Just get some good fuel in me. And then, it's about 16 hours to Moab. Now, why are we going to Moab? Moab is the off-roading capital. It's the Mecca for off-roading capital. And that is arguably one of the most capable off-roading trucks you can buy. So why not put 4 and 4 together and go have some fucking fun? So I've posted on a forum to see if there's anybody who's in Moab who's not a little bitch and doesn't drive that thing to the mall, who actually likes to use it. So hopefully by tomorrow, somebody's like, hey, I have balls, let's go have some fun. And I have somebody who can kind of show me around, because I'll have a way more epic time with somebody since I've never been there before. And obviously there's only so much I can do by myself because safety, and it is brand new, I don't wanna fuck it up. But yeah, so I'd rather have a local who can help me out with this. So that's what we're gonna do, so. So first fill up, since I started the road trip, not counting that first little bit from the border to that gas station, but yeah,
Feeling pretty good so far. It's been, I think, maybe 2 hours, and I got 14 hours more to go. Maybe 13 hours and like 45 minutes. That's actually a long time. And I'm kind of like, holy shit, that's like a full day, legit full day. 55 US, 15 gallons. So anyways, I'm just concentrating now on hammering as many miles in this first little bit while it's early and I'm just feeling good. And we'll see how I'm doing in about 8 hours. Okay, I just stopped for some food, a little snack. I think I have actually crossed into Oregon. I don't know. But holy shit, I forgot how redneck and just small town some of these places were gonna be. I walked in there and it was just, you know, just some different people, nice people, fantastic people, but definitely, you know, they're definitely from this type of, you know, thing. And it's cool. Like, it's cool. Friendly as hell. But yeah, definitely, you know, when you travel like this, you just get to see a mix of so many different kinds of people and things. And that's one of the things I love on fucking road trips like this. So I'll keep you up to date. All right. Excellent. You know what that means. All right, fueling up, what is this, number two, in Ontario, Oregon. And you know, I was thinking that this drive's taking forever. It's a little boring. I don't remember it being this boring. Maybe because I had to focus a little bit more in the older car. But, and then we hit that curvy part of the mountains, or wherever that was, and holy shit, did that wake me the fuck up. So, feeling good. Feeling refreshed. I'm probably gonna get a bit more water because I think I'm still just dehydrated and everything, but I'm feeling better. So how much was it now? $65. The last tank was 55. I have less gas. I just fill up for more gallons of this time around. 15 versus 18. So anyways, things are doing good. On to the next adventure. So remember the Oregon Trail from back in the day? You played on those really old computers. The game was like so hard. I'm at a stop and this is where this is part of where the trail would come. I'm not a history buff, so I'll probably butcher this explanation, but I'll throw up pictures of these things. And if you care, you can read it. But yeah, it's kind of cool. Like the trail would go all the way through here and like, yeah, it's neat. The highway, was it I-84? It's actually called the Old Oregon Trail Highway. So I don't know, I kind of like history that, you know, from back in the day like that, because I used to play that game quite a bit. So it's kind of neat, and it's kind of neat, and not a bad view. So now Salt Lake City is the next stop. We'll see if I can get there before we run out of gas. But yeah, no, coffee. So gotta find McDonald's could do. Yeah, I'll just step over to the McDonald's, grab some coffee, because that's well needed right now. Could that be a storm? We are, on the way to Moab, but the weather is calling for a bit of a storm to come in, and they say it could bring everything from snow higher up to rain to sleet to shit. Should have bought the fucking more expensive thing to a really, really good fucking time. Okay. I saw a sign that said dinosaur query. And then I saw this. And it is fucking windy and dusty. But you know what that means. An adventure. I'm definitely thinking there's a storm coming in. And it's just starting to look really nasty. But it's all good. We're gonna have some fun.
So check this out. Some gravel grass snowbird.
So what that means is it changes all the electronics of the truck, the throttle response, the brake, the ABS sensors, where it distributes torque. It makes it like really, really sensitive to reduce wheel slip. Basically it puts everything in like high freakout mode to ensure that the truck stays straight on like loose and slippery surfaces.
Adventure time.
How's it looking?
I don't know about that one.
Is it? Well, this might be a little risky. I think I'd be a really good explorer from back in the day. Actually, no, you know what? Fuck no. Because as soon as it gets cold or I get wet, I turn into a little bitch. So cancel that. But at heart, I'm an explorer. I have no idea what this dinosaur quarry is. I just kind of saw it side of the highway. Just like, hey, dirt trail, dinosaur something. Let's go check it out. I can't remember how long they said this drive was. But it did say high clearance, four-wheel drive required. So I'm like, check. Sounds like it should be fun. But, you know, it's just like we're in the middle of nowhere. You know, just there's nothing around here except for that guy. So that's cool. Hopefully he's going the same direction I am. So far he is. But, like, there's nothing. Right? And... this is just what, this is how I like to do it. Right? Because the journey, it's not the destination. Not the destination, it's the journey. The once in a lifetime journey. So I'm just kind of chilling around, turn the music off, just kind of relaxing. And I'll keep you updated, see where we end up today. All right. It's a little wet. Check this out. Middle of fucking nowhere. Get me out of the picture. It's like literally nothing around. Nobody around. And you know the craziest thing is? This is actually a state road. Well, that is. This is a grass field. But, like, you don't get this in Canada. At least I've never found places like this in Canada. Where it's like legit, like a state road where you can go 4x4. This is so cool. I'm gonna head back because as far as the map says, the road just keeps going and then it stops. So I don't know if it actually stops or if it just stops in the map, but I'm not gonna bother because it's pretty much all the same terrain and I wanna find something a bit different. So I'm gonna start heading back about like 20 minutes or so back that direction. The direction that the map tells me to go. Wow, I'm fucking lost. Holy shit. Right now, if I did not have a map, I would be fucking lost. Yeah, what way? I'm a city folk. Holy fuck. Anyways, this is so fucking cool. This is exactly what I wanted to be doing. This is exactly it. Middle of nowhere, with the new Range Rover, having a fucking blast. Not even that dirty. We'll keep working on it. It's an off-road height right now, but it is just being a fucking blast. So, anyways, gonna get in there and we'll head back that direction. 5,042 kilometers. That's all it lasted in absolutely untouched mint condition.
Can you see?
Our first war wound.
Ah, fuck me.
Marianne is gonna shit on me about that. Oh, well, whatever. It's just a couple scratches. I'm sure, actually the paint, the protective film I put on it took care of most of that. So it did exactly what I paid for. So I'm sure a body shop can just fucking touch it up, but you can barely even actually fucking notice it. So whatever. Hey, it's a fucking beast. It's supposed to have a little war wounds on it. So life goes on. That's how it is. You have to enjoy your toys. You have to enjoy your toys. You can't just be babying, you know, them all the time like a lot of people do with these trucks. Fucking they're built. Land Rover is built for fucking off-roading. That's what they designed them for. So I'm gonna fucking use it for what it's designed for. All right, back on the freeway for lunch. Scrap lunch in Moab, like in the actual city, and then head over to Colorado, Denver, Boulder. We'll kind of see. And spend the night there. And I'm supposed to hook up with some people there. So hopefully that works out. And yeah, there's a couple more trails I want to try out over there. Because, it's really famous trails like Goldmine Hill. Up around that area. I would love to do is a Black Bear Pass. But one, I think that takes like half a day. Two, I'm by myself. You just can only do so much by yourself. So, I need to get some people to off with. That's what I need. So, anyways, starving because it's like 2 o'clock. That little detour took a few hours. But it was so fun. So I'm walking up to see the world's most famous arch in Moab. It's like a 0.5 kilometer walk. Getting a little chilly. Hopefully it doesn't rain because my jacket is about 1,200 miles west. But should be kind of cool. I still want to do some more off-roading. Honestly, I could be doing that day in and day out. But feels good to be walking for a bit. Done a lot of sitting the last 2 days. So, anyways, let's check this out. Two things. I'm gonna start being a lot healthier. Cause that little walk kicked my ass. Fuck, I gotta get my cardio back up. Second thing is, I didn't even know this was gonna be the arch. Check this out. Hopefully you can see it. Should have brought the other lens. But that's it right there. Now that, you've seen National Geographic magazines, and there's people up there, so you can actually get a lot closer. I don't know how, but oh damn, that'd be so cool. So, that's what I love about these parks. There's just so many cool things to go out and explore. Be like, look around. Wilderness. No, there's people. No buildings. No concrete nuts. Just being out here, middle of nowhere. Seeing, I think it's a national monument. Maybe it's not a national monument, but it's protected. And that's cool. But, yeah, I know this is kind of cool. All right. Trails. Let's go find some trails.
So this is absolutely insane. I thought that climb was going to be a little bit more dramatic, but it just like, well, you saw it. It just like mountain goated his way up there. Just like climbed it like it was just going over a speed bump. Like zero wheel slip at all. At least I couldn't tell. This thing is just nuts. Let's see if I can give you my view. I don't know if the heads up display is showing you what's going on. It shows the pitch and roll of the vehicle, the speed, the gear, what direction the wheels are going. And you can also down here see the diffs opening and so locking and unlocking. So they're dynamic. They can like fully lock, partially lock, all depending on like what the truck needs to be doing right now to maintain momentum and control. All right, gotta call it. The rain is now starting consistently, which means I gotta get out of here because this sand that we're driving on right now, where I'm by myself, that we're on right now, when it gets, it's basically fucked when it's just all wet. So, oh good, and there's a truck coming. So I'm gonna turn around and get on out of here. Good morning. How y'all doing? Check out my wonderful view that's literally just started. But the weather's supposed to be a little insane over the next little bit. And as you go through the mountains, fingers crossed for a freak spring snowstorm. They're calling for it. Hopefully they don't screw it up and it doesn't happen. But on the way to Boulder and the Denver area, gonna do all the shopping we have to do, and this is like the last big thing that I wanted to get done. I'm meeting with the Fastlane truck tomorrow at their headquarters so they can have me on their show, and so I'm just really looking forward to connecting with them. And isn't this so fucking cool? It's like the best feature for when you want to eat or you want to film. You gotta touch it like every 15, 20 seconds or something like that. But it just makes doing this shit a lot easier and driving a lot more dangerous, maybe? I don't know. But so first thing to do when we get to Colorado is go find gold mine trail area. So this is where they do a lot of their testing for their vehicles and stuff like that. So that's step one on the priority list. Step two is haircut, shave. Yeah. And then step three is once I'm done playing around on the dirt, this truck is beyond filthy. Like I was just looking, I was like, oh, there's dirt and dust places I didn't even realize. There's no way I can bring this to Mariana like in the condition it's in. So I'm gonna find not a detailing shop because I got a clone. It's like $400. I'm like, fuck that. But you know, I need somebody to hand wash it properly because I'm just doing it at the wash bays and it's just you can only get so much done. And I definitely, the interior just needs to be kind of cleaned out a little bit better. So anyways, so that's what I'm gonna do. And then as soon as I leave the Denver area, it's back to driving as many miles as possible to get to the Mexican border. You know, there's in Texas, the only things that I want to do
is stop at all the small little towns and hit up those small town diners, because I'm all about that. Small town diner note in Paladice, I think, said howdy to me. So howdy. I'm like, howdy. I just fucking love that lifestyle. It's just so cool. So anyways, hope you all have a great time. Hope you're enjoying these. I'm having a blast making them, as much as I can remember to film and everything, but yeah, so for the drive into to the Denver area has been pretty cool. So let's pray for some freak Colorado spring snow. Just stopped at the No Name Colorado freaking point and just check this out. This is why I love road trips. I stop like a lot. Mariana hates it. I stop so much. This is why it takes me so long. But you know what? Honestly, one, I'll never do this by myself again. I probably won't. At least, no, I never will. Not in a brand new Range Rover. Let me not ruin that shot. Right, you get to do this experience once, so I'm dragging my feet, you know, and I'm just experiencing it the way I want to. I miss the kids so much. Little Raphael is smiling less and less every time he sees me. I think he's starting to get pissed off. Julia just wants her damn toys. I'm pretty sure the wife misses me. Who knows? That's questionable. But this is just so good for the soul, so good for you. This is why you have to go out and do these crazy things, right? So many people will be like, what, you're driving all the way? Why didn't you just buy it in Mexico? Well, fuck that shit, because I wanted to do this. Was this the best idea? It was the best idea for me. Has it been expensive? Yeah, I feel like I'm just spending. Honestly, hotels, accommodations have been a little on the lower side, which has been good. I've been able to find some amazing deals online. I don't think I've paid $100 for a night yet since I've been on the road trip. And I've been staying at like all right places, nothing fancy, just, you know, they're quick overnight because I'm in it for like 7 hours. I don't want anything fancy. But you got to do stuff like this. Whatever your ultimate goal is, whatever your dreams are, whatever, no matter how crazy they are, do them. Don't let other people talk you down. Don't be like, is it sane? Does it make sense? Who the fuck cares? This trip to buy the truck, drive down to Mexico, and then in a few months drive back up, like, it doesn't make financial sense, mental sense. There's no sense. I just want to do it because it's something I want to do. It's an experience. And it goes back to, that's why you have to go out there and make money, so you can go do these things, so you can get your bills taken care of, and then you can go out and live the life that you want to live by doing the things you want to do without worrying about the costs, to a certain extent, right? There's always responsibility, but you can, you know, if I didn't have the money to do this, I'd regret that. I'd be, you know, that just wouldn't be cool. So you have to go out so you can go and, you know, hustle and do your thing, publish your books, so you can go out and live the life that you want to live and do the experiences that you've always dreamt of. Because look at this. Being out in nature is just so cool, right? We got the Colorado River flowing down there. Basically just been following that since who knows when. Right, we're approaching the Rockies over on the other side of that. That's gonna make some epic filming, right? But one life, get as much experience from it as possible. Enjoy it the way you want to enjoy it. no matter what anybody thinks. Did not plan for this weather. I'm cold, don't have my jacket. It's about almost 0 degrees, 32 Fahrenheit. And, yeah, I did not plan for an actual winter, did not really even think about it, but it's all right. Vail, Colorado right now. I believe this is a ski town. So I'm gonna grab some more gas. And then I gotta eat something, and I saw like a sign for like a fried chicken place. I was like, ooh, that would be good. But I can't remember where it was. I don't know if it's like somewhere here or if it's, you know, up a few more exits. So I don't know, I'll probably just Google it, see what we can do, because niggas crave some fried chicken for some reason. Cool. Anyways, so I've been stuck here for like 20 minutes. It could be longer, it could have been 3 days by now. Irrelevant. Apparently there's a 40 car pileup up there, somewhere in the tunnel, out of the tunnel. Bottom line is, this sucks. Also gotta take a leak. But we could be here for a little bit. Damn it. And like, who knows if there's like an emergency pullout, I'm taking it because it's an emergency. But yeah, like shit. This is the only shitty part about mountain travels is like when the road closes, like you're fucked. I'm fucked basically right now. Oh well, at least I'm getting a massage. So, could this have become any more epic? It is dumping snow in, where are we? We are at, what's this town called? Shit, Fresco. Fresco, I just got probably one of my most favorite barbershops I've ever been to. This town is just, the hospitality, those guys were just talking, he was telling me a story, and it was just Taylor. His name's Taylor, the Gentleman's Barbershop in Fresco. Those guys are legit, like just a blast. And I had some delicious lunch as well. But highway is back open, so I'm gonna get going here in a little bit. Just gonna grab some water, probably grab some energy drinks and whatnot. Just been kind of checking out the town. It's this fucking epic snowfall. Look at this. Look at that mountain. Right? You can tell I'm just having a fucking blast. No jacket, a little chilly, but we'll see what the weather's like in Denver. It's probably not gonna be this nice, but this is just so fucking nice. Yep. Wasn't expecting this little present. It's May 20th. May 20th, and honestly, you could think it's like Christmas Eve. Right? Absolutely fine. Those are beyond shit summer tires. Like, beyond shit. They're rated for mud and snow, but they are shit. So, definitely need to get me some winter tires when I get back to Canada, because those are fucking embarrassments. Yeah, anyways, this has been a blast. So, we're gonna get going. My head's getting a little cold, so. All right. Good morning, everybody. It's Tuesday morning here in just north of Boulder, Colorado. It is still snowing outside. I don't know if you can see that. Ever so lightly, it is coming down. So plan today. We are officially at the halfway point. So I'm halfway to Monterey, which is nuts because it feels like it's been so long, but it has been quite, I've done a lot of driving. It's been crazy the last couple days, but just over 20 and a bit hours left of straight driving. And then, what was I gonna say? I don't know, I need more coffee. But I'm staying in the travel lodge right now. And, you know, these hotels, they're all right if you're, I think, kind of by yourself. And, like, I check in, like, 11 o'clock, leave first thing in the morning. So, it's like, I don't really use them. They're great for that. But, man, there are some shady motherfuckers here. Some weird people stay here, including myself. But there's a reason we don't go to these type of hotels when I'm with Raph and the girls. Like, they're just, anyways, I'm gonna go hit up the Fastlane car right now, or after breakfast, do my thing with them. And it's a bummer because the trails I wanted to go hit up, I went to go spot them out last night, and they're all snow covered. Sucks, because like those were some of the main things I wanted to do, but they're snow covered, and those are just bullshit fucking tires. How do they even have a mud and snow rating? Like, who designed that? They're absolutely horrible in the snow. So I can't even risk it, not especially by myself. Like, I'll probably just end up getting stuck. So I ain't gonna risk it, cause I don't have fucking hours to waste like that. So I'm gonna hit up a couple stores, do some shopping, grab a couple things, and then drive south about 7-8 hours to Santa Fe, New Mexico. The barber, who made me look like a fucking Greek god again, told me Santa Fe is just such a cool town. And so it's kind of en route a little bit. So I'm gonna go hit that up, spend the night there. And then I'm going to attempt, how many hours did it say? 14. I'm gonna attempt to drive all the way to McAllen, Texas. I think I'm only gonna get to San Antonio, which is all good. Love San Antonio and I love Texas. But so that'll be the next day. And then the final stretch, like 4 more hours to McAllen and then 2 hours to Monterey. We'll see what happens at the border. And I got my jacket. I got the FedEx label and everything sent to the hotel. So that's good. Feeling better about that. But I'm going to get some grub in me and take care of a bit more work because we got academy class tonight as well. So I just got to do some prep for that. I'm at the Fastlane truck car headquarters. I'm gonna go inside, meet them, chat with them for a bit, do the video. This is so cool though. I'm stoked. Look, you can see there's their Hummer. Right. This should be exciting. So, sounds good. Cool. I'm here in the TFL headquarters, and this is just so cool. Like, I've seen these guys on YouTube and all of that. And, you know, here we are. We got the truck inside, ready to go to do the filming. And it's so neat meeting them, for the first time. But let's go see if we can interrupt their day for a second. And it's just so cool. This place is definitely so cool. Watching these guys on YouTube for hours and hours and hours. And we got Nathan doing his thing over here, working away.
And I was admiring your wheels.
Oh, was that you admiring them?
Guys, oh my God, I love those wheels.
Just,
I know, man.
They're business.
They're business wheels. They just need some proper rubber for this type of weather.
Well, the problem is that I take it off road and I'd immediately destroy the paint on the wheels. It'd just be absolutely obliterated. And then Roman would yell, and then the rubber would yell. Which is why you can take it off road.
Yeah.
You do your stuff and then we'll see what happens.
There you go, right? There you
Bye, guys.
Go. All right. I just set up Target, finished with the fast lane car, and that was awesome, epic. And so now I'm going to hit up Santa Fe, New Mexico. So let's hit the road. I was running to the ocean. Didn't wanna be tied down to nothing. But since I met you, I didn't know it. That underneath it all, you started something. On a Saturday night, I was doing just fine. I was out on my own, didn't want nobody else. Then I opened my eyes and I put down my gas in Las Vegas, New Mexico. Really small United American town here. In fact, one of the gas stations I went to didn't even have proper premium. It was only 90 octane.
It was supposed to be 91.
So anyways, whatever. Yeah. Apparently the faster you go, the more gas you use. I only got 400 kilometers for that tank. Normally I get at least 500. So we'll kind of ease up on the accelerator a little bit, but I just want to make some miles. I want to get home, see the girls, and see Rafi, and see Avengers. So I'm just going to keep going until I'm tired. Roswell, New Mexico is kind of the end destination. We'll see if I go past that, but I kind of want to stay there to check out UFO shit. So keep you posted.
Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous?
Guys, we're here. Well, it was an alright sleep. Definitely not the best, but the sun's up. I was doing some calculations. Might actually make it all the way to Monterey tonight, today. So let's get it done. Bit of a change in weather. Drastically. And why is that a concern? I'm going through an area that still has a tornado watch. And one of the towns that I'm going to be going through got hit with a tornado 2 days ago. I'm all good with snow and heavy rain and everything, but this nigga does not fuck with tornadoes. Mm-mm. All right, so filling up in Texas. I don't know where we are. Somewhere in Texas, along, I think it's Highway 87. Could be 83, could be 81. But, so might actually make it all the way home tonight. So we'll see. Couple hours, gonna call the leasing company. They gotta send me a letter still. Hopefully they're not difficult because, well, they're dealing with me and it'll be more difficult. And I got a contingency plan. And then, I hit up McAllen, hit up Costco, a couple things we got to grab, mostly cereals. Got to grab a couple more things from the auto parts store, some car care shit. I'm probably forgetting something. But yeah, so hopefully the whole deal is I need to cross with daylight, decent daylight. Reynosa is not fucking good place to be at. It's they have serious cartel issues still, and that's where the border is. So you know, yeah, I don't have to fucking take out a whole fucking cartel, changing side on your receipt, but it's more for their safety versus my safety, if anything, right? It'll look bad. One black man taking out a fucking cartel. That ain't gonna look good. So I'm gonna get my receipt, hit the road, and keep making some fucking time.
So we're just going through the heart of Texas right now. About 2 hours from San Antonio. And I don't even know if I'll stop in San Antonio. I'm gonna grab brunch in some little small, the next small town I go through. Then McAllen and then Monterey. So I'll be home tonight. The kids don't know I'm gonna make it home tonight. But yeah, so we're doing good. We're doing good.
110% I'm getting pulled over. 110%. Where are you, buddy? Come on. Where are those fucking blue lights?
Went past some corner. He was going the opposite direction. Put his brakes on. I wasn't even going too fast. Probably like 95. It's a 70. Fuck, where are you?
Not bothering? Are you giving me a fucking break today, bro?
Now, does he radio it in? So I have some surprises coming up over the next few miles?
Okay, nothing is coming over that fucking crest. So clearly he's not giving a fuck.
Alright, we're just gonna chill for a little bit because if I was him, radio it in. Think like a fucking cop.
Check out this little gem. Look at this place. Small town USA. Nothing's better than small town USA. Nothing. I just fucking love these cute little towns. So I'm gonna go hit up Willow for some grub and check in with you guys in a bit.
Breakfast was on point. I had some more chicken fried steak and eggs. And now I just need like a coffee or something. Spike up the energy. Got some Drake going. Gas station. Let's hit this up. Feeling good. Feeling good. Get to see the kiddos tonight. Surprise song. Get to see the wife tonight. You know what that means. The market. All right, let's go to the market. I love fucking small towns, though. So, oh my god, they're just so great. Except we need to talk racism. Does racism exist here? Funny. I'm gonna talk about that in the next video. Alright, there's something going on up on the road. So it's a good time to do a little filming. So anyways, we're gonna talk racism in these small towns. No, I haven't experienced any here. But it is something I always kind of think about when I go into these small towns, because one, everyone always looks when I come in, right? Because maybe there's not a ton of black people around here or whatever. But two, some of these small towns in the USA are fucked up. Maybe it's not so much in Texas. Maybe it's in some of the other states. But you know, some of them are still, you know, they still don't think I should be around. You know, so anyways, we got some cops up here, so I gotta drop the video, but you know, so it's always, you know, kind of thing, but they're always so welcoming. And yeah, you know, the last lady I was talking to, she was just a blast. Like, what a great, she was the owner of Willow's there, that little cafe I went to. And oh, wonderful, wonderful lady.
You know you were not hard, I done made a hat chart. Remember I used to chop hard, living like a rock star, I'm living like a rock star. I've been fucking hoes and
Alright, starting to see U.S. Border Patrol 120 kilometers out from the border. They patrol a big area. All those illegals. Just grabbed some Subway. And so we're going to get to McAllen. This is cops. We're going to get to McAllen in 50 minutes-ish. Depending on traffic. And then Costco, gotta wash the truck because it's absolutely filthy and I've been living in it.
so before the wife sees it. and then we got to fucking deal with the border still. No idea how the border's going to go. Like, it could go super, super easy, or it's Mexico, so shit could just get fucking complicated and stupid. So, a little nervous about that, but she's getting all the paperwork and everything right now. So, we will see. And then, So, this is the bridge you pay tax, you pay toll to go on. Motherfucker, those are big. All right. And now we arrive to the fucking border.
After 300 meters, turn right onto Puente Internacional Hidalgo and then turn right.
Look at that fucking security, huh? Jesus fucking Christ. The war these two countries are at. Alright, so I'm gonna have to fucking pay attention here. Importation, temporary import permits. That's where I wanna go. Holy fuck, I'm in fucking Mexico. Bro, I didn't even fucking stop at the fucking thing. Nobody even looked at my shit. What the fuck?
The course of the road for 3 kilometers.
Holy shit. What the fuck? Am I in? Am I actually in it? I am. What the fuck? I didn't even have to show any ID. Jesus fucking Christ. All right, I gotta figure out where to do this car shit. So I'll hit you guys back in a little bit, all right? All right, so Mexico. They didn't, I had my passport ready. I had my fucking Mexican card ready and nobody was checking shit. They were just fucking waving people in. That was some weird ass shit. Cause last time we got stopped. So now I'm fucking driving around the sketchiest fucking area, Reynosa. I gotta get the fuck out of here. Go ahead. Because it's not fucking good. But so now we're supposed to do the permit for the truck, but that means like going back there, and like I don't want to be driving around this area at all confused, because that's just, you know, ain't fucking good. So I'm gonna get to a fucking highway and get the fuck out of here. Yeah, all right, call you guys in a bit. So definitely coming in was like not exactly what we wanted to do, but here we go. This is better.
Take the next right onto Boulevard Miguel.
Finally, that's what we wanted right there. Monterey. We did not want to be driving through this town. Hiding behind that semi in that road check. So they have like sporadic police checks and shit like that. Sometimes to check, you know, vehicles. We're just hoping we don't run into any of that shit. And it's literally like this for the next 2 hours, then Monterey. So fingers crossed, we are leaving the fucking Badlands. A couple more kilometers. And then it's open fucking highway. Really, really nice highway, because I'm taking the toll route. And it's actually like, it'll New Mexico. The good highways in New Mexico would be equivalent to this. This is super nice. So this is something I haven't really shared with anybody, but this song right here, The Blueprint 2. I used to play this every sale I got for my course. Every sale, like every sale I got, probably for the first like 300. I used to play this song. You know, as a, I don't know, just as a thing, right? It's called The Blueprints. It's one of my favorite songs. And, you know, it's funny. Playing it now in essentially what's my trophy, my reward for making the business work and, you know, clawing our way out of debt and getting us in a good financial position, and bringing it back to Mexico now, to where it all started. As much as I rip on Mexico, hey, fuck, without Mexico, without Monterey, we wouldn't have any of this. I wouldn't have this. So it's kind of, you know, just when the song came on, I was like, shit, this is fucking nuts, because I'm playing it now in the truck that I worked my absolute ass off to get, and it's back here in Mexico now, you know, like I kind of always, you know, imagined it. And yeah, I know, it's cool, it's special. It's special, and you know, it might not mean a lot to you, but these are the things that really, it doesn't matter if it means anything to anybody. It's important to mean something to you, right? And me, for this case, but nah, it's cool. Okay, couple developments. I got a fucking puncture in one of the tires. I didn't have pesos, so I had to take the toll, or I had to take the free route. And the free route is just shit. And all of a sudden, I started getting a notice saying my tire pressure was low. And obviously, didn't hit a pothole or anything. But it's... So I got some sort of puncture in there. So, shit. For one, have to deal with that tomorrow. And I'm just gonna fucking run through that light there. But now, I'm gonna go see the family, see the girls and Rafi. I'm so excited to show them the truck. And let's get their reaction on camera. Can't wait to see their reaction. Who's that?
Daddy, hi.
Finally.
Yeah, bye, Bobby. Let's go from the house.
Rabbit. Hi. I'm here.
Get it.
Here. Put that up. Hi, Raf. Hey.
Mira lo de adentro.
Estaba más que.
Mami, yo también.
Sí, te gusta.
Mira.
Like the girl
playing. All right, made it. Come. All right, made it. 4,700 or so kilometers. I'll get all the stats. And fucking epic trip of the lifetime.
My toys in the back.
Your toys are in the back. Zero tickets. Zero tickets.
See you this.
Just the freaking puncture in the last 10 minutes of the entire trip.
I know.
There's a nail or something in the tire and it's leaking. So I'll deal with that tomorrow. Whatever. It's, you know, it is what it is. But that was That was epic. That was abs. Did you miss Daddy?
Yes.
I know. I miss you so much. But
I miss you so much, Daddy.
It was. That was like one of Daddy's all-time dreams to do that.
Yes.
Yeah.
See.
I know, but wow, it's done. So, anyways, hope you enjoyed the journey, and cannot wait for the next adventure. Are you ready to go on a road trip?
Uh huh.
Yeah.